Hello and welcome to What's in the Night Sky for June 2022. I'm Hayley, and this month I'm going to be talking to you about the first supermoon of the year, how to spot noctilucent clouds, a lineup of the planets, and our constellation of the month, which is Boötes the Herdsman. Let's begin by taking a look at that planetary lineup. So here you can see that I'm looking towards the east on the 1st of June, and we're at 1 o'clock in the morning. So to see the planets this month, you really need to be a very early riser or somebody who goes to bed quite late. So we can see that 1 o'clock in the morning, no planets visible to see. If we take the time onwards a little bit, you can see that just after 1 a.m. Saturn is rising. And then as we go through the morning, you can see that Jupiter and Mars are rising as well. So right at the beginning of the month, you've got this nice lineup of Saturn, Jupiter and Mars, and Jupiter and Mars appearing really close together on the morning of the 1st. So that's a nice pairing of planets to see at the very beginning of the month. If we keep moving through the morning, you can see that Venus rises as well, but the sky is beginning to brighten, the sun is going to be rising, and it becomes harder and harder to see all of these things. If we try and take the time back a little bit, just to see that Venus is rising just after 3:30 in the morning, and you'll need a nice clear horizon to be able to spot this before the sun sets. Opportunities to spot Venus get better as the month goes on, so Venus is a great planet to try and spot this month. If we go further through the month, you can see that Venus just gets a little bit higher the further through the month we go, which means that you can try to look for it while the sky is still a little bit darker. When we get past around the middle of the month, Mercury reaches its greatest western elongation, which means it has its greatest separation from the sun, and we can start to think about how we might spot Mercury. So if I just go a little bit further, getting towards the end of the month, you can see Mercury trying to peek above the horizon here. So Mercury will be very difficult to spot because it's, even though it's at a slightly larger separation from the sun than at other times, it's still close to the sun, and it will you will only be able to see it as the sky is brightening with the sun rising. Let's go a little bit further, right towards the end of the month. And you can see here that we have Mercury. In my view, I've got some annoying trees in the way. See if you can get a nice clear horizon. And you can see that we've got Mercury, Venus, Mars, Jupiter, and Saturn all visible in a line here. So five planets all visible in a line. The thing to do is to go out earlier and try to spot these ones first, and then if you stay up a little bit later and see if you can see Venus rising and then Mercury rising, Venus in Taurus, so you can just about make out the Pleiades here as well, the Seven Sisters star cluster, and Mercury coming along just before 4 o'clock in the morning. So it's a nice opportunity to spot five planets during the month of June. From the middle of the month onwards is the best time. You should certainly be able to see the brightest four, Saturn, Jupiter, Mars and Venus. Mercury a little bit more difficult. One way that might help you to spot Venus and Mercury is if you do it around the 26th, 27th, because they are joined by the moon. The crescent moon, so that might just help you to find the right location, and actually this is a really nice group of objects, the Pleiades, the very thin crescent moon and Venus, and if you have a clear horizon you might just be able to do it when it's a little bit darker. The darker it can be when you go out, the better really for that. So that's a little tip for helping you to find where Venus and Mercury are. Venus will be really, really bright. Mercury will be a little bit more difficult to spot. You could try adding another two planets to make yourself a seven planet lineup instead of a five planet lineup, by having a look for Uranus and Neptune. Much, much more difficult. Neither of them will be easy to spot. You can see Uranus is here, between Venus and Mars, and you want to do it when the sky is a bit darker. So if you come out a bit earlier, and have a go at spotting Uranus. So, you will need a pair of binoculars or a small telescope. Through a pair of binoculars, it will look like a star. You won't really be able to tell the difference between it and the surrounding stars. If you have a small telescope, you might be able to spot a greenish coloured disk. And for Neptune, if we just zoom out, so we go past Mars and Jupiter, and between Jupiter and Saturn, we have Neptune. Again, a very tricky target, but if you like a challenge and you have a small telescope, then you could also have a go at spotting Neptune. One more thing to say about this lineup before we leave it behind is that the moon joins the party from the middle of the month. So if we just go back to the 19th, there we go. So the 19th, you can see the moon is over here by Saturn. So a gibbous phase moon, just over half illuminated, and then you can see the way that the moon moves over that few days. So it moves towards Jupiter, making its closest approach to Jupiter on the 21st, 22nd, and then the 23rd for Mars, and then the 26th, 27th, it's close to Mercury and Venus, as we've talked about already. So this is a really, really good month to take in all of the planets and take them in with the moon if you go out on the right days as well. Let's leave the planets behind now, but stay with the moon. And I'm going to take us to the 14th of June, which is when the full moon occurs. And whoops, let's go backwards so that we can see it. So the 14th of June is when the full moon occurs, and it is the first of three supermoons in a row for this year. And a supermoon occurs because the moon has an elliptical orbit, which means that the distance between it and the Earth varies throughout the month. And when the full moon happens around the time that the moon is closest to the Earth, we call it a supermoon. The June moon is also sometimes known as the strawberry moon because it marks the start of strawberry picking season. Another thing you can look out for when we have the supermoon is to see if you can spot the moon illusion. And the moon illusion is when the full moon appears closer to the horizon, which makes it appear larger to us. And a really good time to look out for the moon illusion would be around 11 o'clock. So if you look around 11 o'clock on the 14th of June, you will see, providing the sky is clear, you will see the full supermoon close to the horizon. And that effect of it appearing larger because it's close to the horizon can be quite spectacular. So it's a really good thing to get out and see if you have the chance. The next thing I want to talk to you about this month is Noctilucent cloud season, something that I really enjoy, and it's now begun and will last until early August. And Noctilucent clouds are caused by high altitude ice clouds, and when the sun dips below the horizon, they reflect the sunlight, even though for us on the ground it's already dark. And the result is these spectacular glowing clouds, night shining clouds. The way to spot them is to look to the horizon. If you're going to look after sunset, then you want to look to the northwestern horizon. So let's swing around to the northwestern horizon. And you want to look around an hour and a half to 2 hours after sunset. So if we go back to the beginning of the month, beginning of June, the sun will be setting around 9:15 or so. So if you look up until around 11 o'clock, then you have a chance to see these night shining clouds. So look fairly low to the horizon after sunset, around an hour and a half to 2 hours after sunset, or if you prefer to get up early in the morning and look before sunrise, then you can do the same thing look above the northeastern horizon an hour and a half to 2 hours before sunset. See if you can spot these night shining clouds. Let's finish by taking a look at our constellation of the month for June, which is Bootes the Herdsman. I'm just going to take us to a little bit later, and you can see Bootes depicted here. I'm just going to put the art on so that you can see the herdsman. Sometimes it's depicted as the herdsman driving his great plough around the sky, the great plough being, of course, the asterism, the plough or the Big Dipper. This is also the way to find Bootes. Most of us are familiar with this asterism. It's nice and easy to spot in the night sky, and you can follow the handle or follow the arc to Arcturus. Arcturus is one of the brightest stars in the night sky, so it will be nice and easy to spot. And I wanted to talk about it this month because it is like our sun but in a later stage, so it will follow the same sort of life path that our sun is following. So it's a red giant star, and when you have a look at it, if you look with your naked eye or with a pair of binoculars, you might be able to detect the orangey red colour of it. That shows that it is a red giant star in the final stages of its life. Having run out of hydrogen fuel to fuse into helium, it's swelled to a huge size and will eventually lose all of its outer layers, leaving behind a tiny white dwarf star, the same fate that we can expect for our sun in about 5 billion years time. And I find it quite interesting to look at these red giant stars and think about our sun going through a similar cycle in billions of years time, when none of us are still here. That brings me to the end of our tour of the night sky for June 2022. I hope that you have clear skies this month to be able to get out and observe all of the things that we've talked about.